But yes, from here we move on to the policy that any action that happens on the ground is under a policy direction. So that is something for which we have Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, who is the Principal Secretary, IT and Industries from the government of Telangana, talking to us on a policy for revival. And his focus would be on creating and talking about examples which have been set by his department in the state, giving hand-holding support to the institutions, creating real business opportunities, attracting investments and taking additional measures just to keep everything rolling while the government, while the world came to a stop, grinding halt, he carried on. And the knowledge that he has created should be shared from the state's prism, also to be amplified nationally to help other states to benefit and make their own innovative plans. Mr. Jayesh Ranjan.
Thank you very much, Dr. Gursharan. Very happy to be on this platform. As you mentioned, I'll be speaking largely in the context of MSMEs in the government of Telangana. I look after the subjects of industries and information technology, and MSMEs is a subject that I look after. So I'll speak about what we have done in the last 6 months or so for the MSME sector. So as all of us would understand, because of the pandemic, because of the lockdown, different sectors of the economy have been impacted, some quite adversely. But we should also look at this particular fact that within each sector also, there is lots of heterogeneity. I mean, there are some large players, there are some startups, but then there is a bunch of companies which we will call as MSMEs. These are small, mid-scale, micro companies, and in multiple sectors, sector after sector after sector, we have seen the kind of disruption which the pandemic has brought has resulted in some very adverse and serious consequences on the MSME sector. So I'll speak about what has been our response to MSMEs' problems and difficulties in this COVID times. As we know, while many large industries have also been impacted, but obviously they have deep pockets, they have the resilience, they have the wherewithal to kind of come back. And when things get normal, as we are already seeing, there are green shoots in the economy and there is some kind of a rebound which is going around in the larger companies. But MSMEs have special and peculiar difficulties, and I would like to answer that or speak about that. So we have, first of all, in Telangana, as early as April, in fact, once we realized that this lockdown is going to be there for some time and there'll be a disruption of multiple kinds, we have started focusing on the key MSME sectors which are important for the state of Telangana. So we have identified four such sectors where we have the presence of a large number of MSMEs. So some of you would know that Hyderabad is a very important center for pharmaceuticals, biotechnology, life sciences, etc. So that is one sector that we have taken. Hyderabad is also very important for defense electronics. Some of you would know that Hyderabad has a large number of defense labs, private companies, government PSUs, which are into manufacturing, R&D, and this whole ecosystem has also spawned a large number of MSMEs. In fact, as per our data, there are more than 1,000 MSMEs which are manufacturing all kinds of defense and aerospace related components. Similarly, we found that though it is not that well known outside, but we have a large food processing sector also, and there are large number of MSMEs which are in the textile sector, particularly in the spinning and ginning sectors. So we chose these four sectors to find out what exactly are the challenges which MSMEs face. And we found different kind of things. So in some sector, for example, the labor has just vanished. Most of them were reliant on migrant labor, and therefore the labor has gone away. In some sector, for example, this is very true of the pharma sector. We found that lots of critical raw material are not manufactured in Hyderabad. They're coming from outside. They're coming from Gujarat, or they're coming from Maharashtra. And because of the supply chain problems, transportation problems, there was a bottleneck in getting those kind of raw materials into the city, into the manufacturing unit. And therefore, the MSMEs were able to, because they don't maintain a very huge inventory, unlike the large companies, they faced difficulty. So different kinds of problems, labor problem, as I said, raw material problem. In some sectors, the consumer preferences have changed altogether. In textiles, for example, people will not be now, by and large, spending too much of money on very high-end kind of, very luxury kind of clothes, etc. So consumer changing consumer preferences was another thing. And of course, shortage of working capital, etc., were common problems across the sector. So what we did was that with the help of the industry association, which again includes larger players also, we tried to find solutions on some of these problems. So let us say skilled labor is a problem. All your labor used to come from Orissa or elsewhere, and they have all moved away, and you are unsure whether they will come back or not. So can we find a local solution to it? So we did a deeper dive to find out what exact skills do these have, these outside laborers have. Why is it difficult to translate or teach the same skills to our local youth? If that has to be done, what kind of institutions have to be set up? What kind of training infrastructure or skilling infrastructure has to be set up? Can the industry association do something by themselves? Does the government require to set in? Similarly, I told you that certain sectors are affected by raw material problem because the raw material comes from outside. So the obvious question was to ask was that, can we start manufacturing these raw material here itself, very close to where the end users are located? Can we find a small industrial park where a separate zone is created for these raw material industries? Can they be given some incentives to set up their factories or their manufacturing units in Telangana? Can the government give to them some kind of a buyback agreement that whatever you produce here will be consumed? So all these kind of solutions have been thought of in a very comprehensive way.
Having some connectivity issue there.
So Gurshan, could we move on to the order of merit batch 2 while he joins? Or
I think because of the connectivity he got dropped out.
No, so, I'm sorry.
Okay, wonderful. Okay.
Yeah. I thought, Dr. Gurushan, that you have cut me the way
we would dare not.
No, but if I'm running ahead of time, do let me know. You're
pretty much well within time and we are enjoying your conversation. Your talk.
Thank you. But anyway, I know that you have a day-long agenda. So I'll speak of the next few points as crisply as I can. So I'm glad that this interlude has given a segue to move to the next part. But the first part, the summary is that if you really want to help the MSMEs identify what are their pain points, and most of these pain points have a solution. The government has some solution, some part of the solution to offer, and the rest of them, particularly their associations themselves, will come forward because they have all seen the pandemic. They have all seen what kind of difficulties they will face if they don't really respond at this point in time. So use this as an opportunity to galvanize their association and work out in finding and implementing these kind of joint solutions. The next thing which I wanted to speak about briefly was on the Atmanirbhar schemes which the national government has introduced for MSMEs. So as all of us know, there are three specific schemes which have been announced. The first one is, of course, an emergency loan scheme, which every other state in the country has really taken up in a very serious way. So in Telangana also, we have been able to conduct meetings with the banks at the central level, at the district level. We have given a list of all the MSME borrowers to the district officers so that the scheme is not run only through the efforts of the banks. I mean, the banks, of course, will do whatever best they can do, but we are supplementing their efforts by putting our industrial field officers, promotion officers, the district level development agencies, etc. And every borrower is contacted by us. We tell them about this scheme. And there is an effort to maximize whatever is the possibility in Telangana. So again, I'm very happy to share that the manufacturing sector by and large has been able to benefit out of this emergency loan scheme completely. And the service sector, there are a few who personally feel that the service activity is not viable enough to take an additional loan. And even though there is a generous moratorium and a small rate of interest, many of them are skeptical about the ability to even repay that amount after a moratorium. So service sector has not really gone 100% for this scheme, but the manufacturing sector in the MSMEs definitely has. But it is the second scheme which has been announced under the Atmanirbhar package, which gives me lots of pride. See, the second scheme is on what is called a distressed the MSMEs which are facing a situation of distress, they are already declared as NPS. And the scheme is to provide to them a subordinate debt in the form of equity. So here we take lots of pride in sharing this, that there is a organization that we have created almost 3.5 years ago. This is a very unique organization, first of its kind institution in the country, which is called the Telangana Industrial Health Clinic, TIHC. Of course, 3 years back, 3.5 years back when we formed this, we had no ideas about this COVID. But at that point in time, it was created because when the state was a part of the combined state of Andhra Pradesh, in just before the formation of the state, which happened in 2014, a few years before that, starting from 2010 onwards, there was a severe energy crisis in the state and MSMEs were the biggest sufferers. Many MSMEs had to shut down at that point in time because they just had no access to power, and most of them remained sick after Telangana came into being also. So we created this institution basically to revive Sikh industries. And this is a very good setup. We have taken lots of professional bankers in that institution. The leadership is very strong. We use technology tools to evaluate the level of sickness and what methods are required to revive that. So now when the subordinate debt scheme has been introduced by Government of India as a part of Atmanirbhar, our preparedness to bring the best of this scheme to the most needed MSMEs which are facing distress, which are in the state of NPA, that is the best, so to say. So we are very confident that this scheme will see a very methodical, scientific, and normally banks have issues. If you tell them that I'm asking you to support a Sikh MSME or an MSME which has gone into an NPA status, they have lots of reluctance. But because of our preparedness, these institutions, and when we tell them that we are developing a revival plan which will guarantee more or less that your money, the second investment that you are making, will actually bear fruits, the confidence level goes up much more. So I'm very confident that this scheme will do very, very well in Telangana. Of course, we are waiting for more details of the third scheme, which is a fund of fund schemes. That is not for Sikh MSMEs. That is for the ones which perform the best. And we are confident that once those guidelines come out, we will be able to do quite well in that also. The last 2 minutes, which I would like to take, is to speak about digital. I'm also the IT secretary in the state of Telangana. And one lesson which COVID has taught us is that the world is going to go more and more digital. We have already seen how education, healthcare, and various other activities, where earlier there used to be a face-to-face interaction, you have to submit papers, you have to submit documents, everything is becoming paperless, everything is becoming faceless. So what is the possibility of our MSMEs going digital? So I would share something very educative and very illuminative here. About 5-6 years ago, there is a consultancy firm called Dun and Bradstreet. They had done a survey of the MSMEs in Telangana, mostly in and around Hyderabad, on what kind of digital footprints do they have. And they had prepared a questionnaire which had on the one end very basic things like, does the owner of that MSME, does he use an email or not? Two questions like, do you have a ERP system? Do you use software like Tally, etc.? And on the other end, they had more kind of advanced questions like, do you have a full-fledged ERP? Are you on e-commerce? Is there a website of your company? And so on and so forth. So 5 years ago, I remember I had only released that report. And I remember there was an astonishing finding that about 70% of the MSMEs of Telangana, of course, this was a sample, they did not survey everyone, but in their sample, they found out that 70% of the MSMEs did not even have an email account. So they were, I mean, normally in our English language, we say that we should go up the ladder, we should move up the value chain. But here is a scenario where people don't even see the ladder. There is the question of going up on the ladder. The ladder is not even visible to 70% of the people. So again, so from that stage to what kind of digitization imperative is there in the world now, we have to traverse a long distance. But again, I'm very glad to share with you that COVID has given us lots of optimism and hope. I'll give you just one example, and that will be the last thing that I'll share. As you know, during the lockdown period, while mainstream e-commerce companies like Amazon and Big Basket, they were all there. But obviously the smaller grocery stores, typically which are there in small neighborhoods, etc. And normally with these kind of grocery stores, we have a strong relationship. I mean, we shop for petty things there. Our fathers would have shopped there. Our grandfathers would have shopped there. So there's a neighborly kind of a family kind of a feeling. And of course, when there is a lockdown, all these people are affected the most. So what we did was in Telangana, with the help of an agency called Global Linkers, we converted almost 1,000+ such Kirana stores or grocery stores into digital stores. And this happened literally overnight. So every store got an ID, whatever inventory you have was digitized. A payment gateway was created, online ordering was facilitated. So in these times also, if you want to support your local grocery using digital, you can do that. And again, as I said, the uptake was amazing. I mean, thousands of people came up and signed up for it. And even today, they are functioning very well. So the digital push for MSMEs, regardless of what kind of activities were, will be very important. And that should be the next big priority for all of us here in Telangana. So it was a pleasure, Dr. Gurusharan, sharing our experiences of supporting the MSMEs here, and look forward to hearing experiences and opinions of rest of the panel also. Thank you very much.
Jayashji, if I may, you know, we kind of all look forward to what Telangana is going to do next. And one of the things where, you know, the entire country has given up, and I would really wish to see leadership from you, specifically is the services. You also mentioned that a lot of, you know, there is so much of lack of hope and darkness in front of them. And perfectly reliable, revivable services companies would not want to take additional loan, you know, because they can't see the runway. Because the uncertainty of when the COVID will be over and when the crisis will start again. So I think it's imperative that an equity support and this fund of funds scheme that you've done is focused on the services sector. It would be a tragedy if such a brilliant services sector that is there in Telangana and elsewhere in the country dies because no one has the vision. And you know, they've historically had zero credit support. In fact, it's not the market to give credit, it's the market to give credit. And if you could take the lead there and show the path to the rest of the country, how Telangana supports the services sector, I think it would be human service to the state as well as the country.
No, absolutely, Samirji. 100% agree with you.